Hello and welcome to this October edition of Amundi's Market Review. With the third quarter of 2020 just ended, it's time to look back and take stock. Recent news flows on COVID-19 show we are still in the grip of the pandemic. True, we are better equipped, but the toll of the pandemic continued to rise. In the third quarter of 2020, we expected growth to rebound, which did occur indeed, even outpacing our expectations, in the US in particular, where the recovery continues and unemployment is surprising on the positive side, declining faster than expected. When compared to August, policy boosters have been watered down. As a matter of fact, we have little visibility on phase 4 of the US bipartisan government spending deal. In the EU, the new wave of COVID-19 hampers the transition from policy measures oriented at damage containment to reconstruction policies. Meanwhile, in China, where the recovery continues on exports and services, the need of policy accelerators is less essential. Rates remain low, credit spreads are artificially compressed, this is what we call easy financial conditions, and leaves central banks with a less urgency to intervene. As such, entering the final quarter of 2020, financial markets will be paying attention to economic data, a US fiscal stimulus, the US elections, Brexit, and obviously COVID-19 related news. This is exactly what we are seeing currently, in the US in particular, with equity markets correcting the extreme polarization of previous highs. This is especially true in the tech sector, where big tech stocks have seen a welcome pullback. More generally, with the exception of the Hang Seng China, major regional stock indices closed the quarter with positive performances. However, in September, the end-of-the-month rebound in global equities reversed. Investors are scaling back the US fiscal stimulus proposal and at the same time growing fears on the pandemic. We had more than 1 million fatalities. Investors are now looking for direction. In September, the S&P 500 lost more than 4%, Europe minus 1%, TOPIX more than 3%. In the credit market, spreads widened somewhat, but remained well below end-of-June levels. Nominal and real rates continue to drift broadly lower. Eventually, the US dollar strengthened back to 1.17 versus the euro, thanks to its standing as a safe haven asset. The resurgence of commodities, and more specifically base and precious metals, benefited Latin American countries. The Brexit cliff risk returned center stage from September, with tension on the rise again. We expect a partial trade deal to be reached in the fourth quarter. In the meanwhile, sterling remains highly volatile and UK stocks continue to move sideways. Entering this year's final quarter, we expect a growing but slowing economic scenario subject to downside risk from COVID-19 related news. The path to recovery is on a positive but smoother trend. In conclusion, at present time, markets are pricing for a low inflation, low growth, low rates environment, and for the ability of monetary and fiscal policies to continue to support and temper markets volatility. The current readjustment is mainly due to investor repositioning and is not driven by a rising financial market stress. We keep monitoring divergences and dislocations, being ready to possibly rotate and mitigate risk exposure when visibility on fundamentals will be higher. Thank you for listening. Please keep safe and see you next month for another market review.